I decided to watch a movie called Jack and Jack Jack and Adam Sandler. Okay, so this is a movie that came out in 1914, and from what I've heard, it was a great movie. I lost my copy in an unfortunate accident, so I cannot watch it again. Since I was half asleep while watching it the whole time, and also on drugs, I decided to rewatch it, but like I said a minute ago, I lost the DVD in an unfortunate accident. The best part of the movie is the part where Adam Sandler calls the friendly black man that lives down the street the N-word, and then he burns a cross in his front yard. I think this added some much-needed comic relief to an overall depressing film about how a man goes delusional and starts dressing like a woman and pretending as if he was his own twin. This whole movie overall was more depressing and sad and overall better than any movie that's come before. Synecdoche, New York, if you thought that was a depressing movie, you have never seen Jack and Jill. Because in Jack and Jill, what happens is this guy, he and his wife, played by Katie Couric, they're trying to make sense of Adam Sandler's illness. Adam Sandler obviously doesn't like that idea, so he decides, instead of coping with his mental illness, he creates a sister. A twin sister. So he dresses up in drag, you know, buys a wig, gets women's clothing, everything like that. And he dresses up like a woman. And he acts as if he's his own twin sister. And he brainwashes his children into thinking that his mental illness is normal and that he really does have a twin sister. So around Hanukkah time, he breaks out in drag and decides, hey, I'm gonna make my whole family play along with my little game here. So, he spends time with his family and friends dressed as this woman. He even goes to a Mexican party and dresses up as Jill, his twin sister.
Eventually, Adam Sandler convinces himself that Al Pacino is living in his house. He is obviously delusional, as no one like Al Pacino would ever agree to live with Adam Sandler, let alone be in one of his fucking movies.
Well, that was the end of my wacky movie review. Tune in next time for another funny Adam Sandler movie review. Okay, I give this movie a solid 10 out of 10. It's really good.